and personal courage. So just in case you want a title for this, it's coming from soldier to servant. Remember this one. Soldier to servant. When this man of God tell me, look, you've lost your faith, you got to get back in close proximity with God. You see, I was like David. I disconnected. You remember when David disconnected from God, what happened? The Bible said it was the month of spring when kings should be at war.
Right.
But instead, David was at home.
Yes.
Instead of being at war, David was at home. So you know he got into issues with Bathsheba and everything else. Because we were out of place. Some things happen when you're out of place. You get PTSD when you're out of place. You can't sleep when you're out of place. But the thing is, I had to get in position.
That's it.
You see, I'm like Nehemiah. You remember Nehemiah chapter 1? When they told Nehemiah, Nehemiah asked, what is happening with the people of Israel?
My goodness.
Yes, this is what he said, Pastor. The news came back, Pastor. Life in Jerusalem is not good.
Right.
Well,
I'm here to talk to I'm here to talk to the saints of God. You see, you come to church every day and you don't understand. You're an ambassador of Christ.
That's right.
I didn't get that this bullet wound was to make me an ambassador of Christ. I didn't get that I had to praise his name. That every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that he's the true and the living God.
Right.
I didn't realize that. I met a man of God and he put hands on me. That's another important part.
Yeah.
You don't want to get close. Because if the man of God put his hands on you, he will reveal God's will for your life and not yours. So you don't want to get close to the pastor. But anyway, he put hands on me. He said, the Lord require your service. This is what he said. There goes the word service again.
Yeah.
It's not only for us that was in the military, but it's for everybody sitting here. Many women of God, I'm here to tell you, they told Nehemiah things wasn't good. The Bible said he prayed and he fasted.
That's right.
We don't pray and fast anymore.
Come on.
Pastor, when we pray and fast, we get close proximity with God.
Yes, we do.
So we can hear and listen to his answer when we pray.
Amen.
Some of us were like Daniel. He knows when we open our mouth, he sends the angels swiftly to take care of our issues. But if you're sitting here today, Pastor, I'm bringing it to a close. If you're sitting here today, whether you are past military or not, the Lord is requiring service from you. And you want to ask me how? Well, first of all, you've been through some things. Some of us have been through some trials and tribulations. The Bible said, pick up your cross daily and follow me. Well, if the Bible said, pick up your cross daily and follow me, that means that he's leading you somewhere.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
You got somewhere.
So you have some issues right now. But the Lord is going to lead you to safety.
That's it.
You got to get this thing. Your cross could get heavy. By the way, the cross was heavy for Jesus too.
Yes, it was.
You got to get it. Cephas helped him carry it. Amen?
Amen?
But there was something that was supposed to happen. He was supposed to serve us to the very end.
Yes,
sir. Pastor, Bishop, we forget about the very end. We start serving in the military. We're the best soldiers.
Yeah.
But when we walk through the church door,
yeah,
service is gone.
Oh,
I'm sorry if I'm stepping on our feet. But look, when we walk through the door, service is gone.
Right.
The pastor called, you don't answer the phone. He sent you a text, you don't answer the phone. And he wants something done, he can't find you.
Oh,
this is service, y'all. Jesus gave up humanity, divinity for humanity. Do you understand what Jesus did? And I'm going to close it right here, Pastor, I promise. I got to give you this piece right here. God took a chance on sending Jesus to save us. I know you're saying, explain it, I will. First of all, he gave Jesus a human body. Pastor Bishop, we have limitations in our human bodies. Do you remember the part when Jesus said, Lord, can you take this cup from me? That was the human limitation speaking, y'all. This is what the Lord did for us. This is how much he loves us. And he requires something of us. Amen. Salvation is not just free. First of all, it costs, Bishop, drops were wasted, the blood of Jesus. I'm sorry, you can say what you want to when I leave. But we're wasting the blood of Jesus. Here's why. We're not grateful anymore. We're not humble anymore. We're not teachable anymore. So when the pastor speaks, the word goes in and it comes out, and then there's no application. I'm here to tell you today, somebody is watching you. Somebody's soul salvation requires what you're doing in your life. They're watching, Pastor, what you're doing. Matter of fact, this young pastor, I'm watching, and I'm learning, and I'm blessing in the process. So I'm here to tell you today, service for our country was great. Some people call me a war hero and everything else. That's not important. You want to know what's important? Serving God till the day I die. For God I live. For God I die. And I leave that with you. From service to servant. No more sitting in the pews, y'all. Get it ready. Serve the Lord while he's near. Serve the Lord while you're in the land of the living. So when they wheel you into the church, your spirit is already gone. By the way, we love to talk when people die. I hope he's doing this, and I hope when I go, I hope you don't hope for me. I don't need you to hope for me, because I serve a God that's real, y'all. I serve a God that I know one day I'm going to knock on that door, and he's going to say, welcome in, my good and faithful. Hold on. The word is servant. He didn't say